Scully Avenue and Dodger Stadium. First place teams match up this afternoon on TBS, the Dodgers and the Cubs. What a great series matchup, the third and final game. And that's just part of the story because Vin Scully is here as well. It's his 67th and final year, the greatest voice in sports history on display all season long. And hi, everybody. We welcome you from Chavez Ravine at Dodger Stadium. I'm Brian Anderson. We'll hear from Cal Ripken Jr. in just a moment. And while we're excited about this matchup today, it's going to be a dandy game three, the rubber game between the Cubs and the Los Angeles Dodgers. We have a special treat for you. We thought we'd put together the guy who's played in the most consecutive games in Major League history with the man who has called the most games in Major League Baseball history. Enjoy this. Legends, Cal Ripken Jr. interviews Vin Scully.
Well, Vin, I had a chance to retire on my own terms. And when I decided to make that public, it turned into one long goodbye. Now, that was only after 21 years. You've had 67 years, and you're retiring. How is your long goodbye?
Well, you know, it is kind of painful. At the same time, for me, I keep thinking, I'm not saying goodbye as much as I'm celebrating Thanksgiving. I have been so fortunate to have been doing this since I was a very young fella for 67 years. I have nothing to be sad about, so I'm very thankful. But you're right, it's longer and harder than I imagined.
Well, so you have all the players come up, you know, how does that make you feel that all the players come up and wish you goodbye?
Well, some of them I understand, Cal, because they come from Southern California, and after they were born, the only voice they heard for a long time was me jabbering away with the Dodgers, so I can understand when they come up. Every now and then there'll be somebody who surprises me, like David Ortiz of the Red Sox. And what's also nice, the umpires come up and some of the managers come up. Joe Maddon has come up twice, bringing me all kinds of stuff. So that part of it's a lot of fun. How about that with you? I mean, people, did it be more than just a handshake?
Well, I mean, it was a little overwhelming, a little bit emotional for me. But in hindsight, I think it allowed me to put it to bed, to bring closure to it, instead of just waiting till the end and saying goodbye. But it was hard.
I have a question for you.
Sure.
You give it up and you go to the ballpark. Do you wish you were back out playing?
I don't think there's 1 minute that I wish that I was competing. I know I played 3,001 games, I think, darn near all of them in a row. And I know what it feels like to succeed, but I do miss the people. And I think maybe that's what you're going to miss. I miss the trainers. I miss the clubhouse guys. I miss all the people that were in the insides of the stadium.
I'm the same way. From the moment I come to Dodger Stadium, I say hello to the lady on the elevator. I've seen her every day for years. And then we go right on through. When I get into the booth, it's my second home. I'll probably miss that more than anything. Plus, the roar of the crowd. How about that?
That's a pretty good feeling, coming through in the clutch. Let me ask you one question. I've heard your stories. I love your stories, and you've given them to so many people over the years. What's the story about when you loved the game first, as a player?
No, but I tried to play, which is really why I love the game. I played high school ball, played college ball. My great moment of fame was I played against George Herbert Walker Bush, who was the first baseman at Yale, and I met him and we chatted. We both went 0 for 3, by the way. But no, I started as an 8.5-year-old, 9-year-old, walking home from grammar school, and I went by a Chinese laundry, and there was a line score in the window, and I stopped to look, and the Yankees had beaten the Giants 18-4 in a World Series game, imagine. And as a little boy, my heart went out to the Giants. I thought, oh, those poor Giants. Well, my school was about 20 blocks from the old Polo Grounds. The game started at 3:15. I got out at 2:30. Because of two different organizations, I could go free from Monday to Friday. So I became a rabid Giants fan. Well, what's interesting was, when I saw that score, that was October the 2nd, 1936. My last game, God willing, will be in San Francisco with the Giants, October the 2nd, 2016. It will be exactly 80 years to the day. So that's kind of poignant and wonderful for me.
Ben, I can't thank you enough for taking time out.
I'm delighted to have a chance to say hello. You've been in another world. We have watched and worshipped you from afar. So it's awfully good to have you in our booth.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Oh, those are two baseball icons. Great job, Cal Ripken Jr. with the greatest voice of all time. There will never be another Vin Scully. We are